Here lies a war hero, a real one. An officer who prevailed over the enemy in a historic battle that led a nation to freedom. His name is Conrado Rigor Sr., the major who led a six-month resistance in Besang Pass that drove the Japanese out of Ilocos Sur in the Second World War. Rigor's men destroyed one of the last remaining Japanese strongholds in the north and became key to their eventual surrender. The Japanese soldiers surrendered the flag of their commander, General Tomoyuki Yamashita, to the young Major Rigor. That flag was passed on to his children and is now stored safely in a vault in the United States.
We really hold it very dearly for us, you know. Malaking bagay sa aming mga kapatid yan. This one is a family parang heirloom na, no? But we low-key lang ang family namin kasi so hindi namin masyado in-announce.
The Rigor family reached out to ABS-CBN News to reveal how their father's story intertwines with that of Ferdinand Marcos.
Quiet lang kami as family. But when ghostwriters came out with books claiming that he was the hero of Besang Pass, medyo maalma-alma na kami. You know, cannot be. You know, dad is the real hero of Besang Pass. And we rightfully claim that. He cannot do that to us. And we have the proof.
Manuel is seventh of nine children. He said that when his father died of a heart attack in 1960, it was Marcos who gave the eulogy. He is, after all, a friend of his father and mother, Erlinda Nicolas, from their college days in the University of the Philippines. In 1964, however, when Ferdinand Marcos published his biography, they were surprised that he took credit for the battle at Besang Pass.
The credit was taken from him. You know, kaya merong tampo ang pamilya as far as the Marcoses were concerned. You know, para bang, why did they allow it? Mm-hmm. In fact, they did not even correct it. Kumbaga, they basked in the glory of, you know, someone else's credit.
Was Marcos in Besang Pass?
He was never in Besang Pass. He was far from it. What he said during that time, he was there. And including some of those who participated dun sa Besang, the friends of my dad, they were the ones who said na that's not true.
His mother, Erlinda, served as Marcos's secretary for a long time, and the family thought it best to keep their silence. They were silent even in 1986 when the international press started writing about the allegation that Marcos faked his war record. But with the recent decision of President Rodrigo Duterte to bury the late dictator at the Libingan ng mga Bayani alongside heroes like his father, Manuel decided to speak up.
I cannot seem to accept that somebody else would claim my dad's medals or his credit, you know. So that for me is foul, you know. And after martial law, there was no remorse, no apology from the Marcoses whatsoever. Kaya I'm against his burial. Sana kung marireconsider lang ni President Duterte. Mahal naman siya sa Ilocos. Kahit na doon na lang siya ilibing, kahit dalawang Taj Mahal pa ang gawin niyo in his honor, just do what is right. We do know what is right.
Says Orenia Drilon, ABS-CBN News.